joining me and the Old Grumpy Prosperity team for this week's episode of Grow Your Mind and Money. And tonight we are interviewing Kevin Hopkins. He's the founder and CEO of Together We Change, one-time flyer delivery service, and on-time productions. Now, Kevin has experienced the other side of the mountain, the valley, and the mountaintop, and has used those challenges in transforming himself in ways that has had him be the angel maker of the media and entertainment industry. And Kevin's vision, pragmatic approach, and transformative techniques have made the difference for performers and businesses to succeed and even exceed expectations. And of course, Kevin is a champion for humanity. Yes, it is time for a little spoken word to kick off our show from none other than yours truly, the beautiful Miss Shani, the original Sunshine Princess of Poetry.
Hey, 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 it's Shani the Poet, the original Sunshine Princess of Poetry, and welcome. We have something awesome for you, something new. Tell me how you feel about trust. I don't trust you. You play with my heart carelessly, pulling at my heartstrings vigorously, taunting my emotions with love forever. Weather storms and promises of protection, I don't trust you. You tell me that it was love at first sight. Ask me where I've been all your life. Ask me to share your life. Tell me that you would do life if that were the case, because I'm your baby. You leave your hugs on my spirit. Your touch is sewn into my skin. And when I look at you, you look lost to our memory. Mesmerize as if you love me for lifetimes. I don't trust you. You pull me close to push me away, sometimes keeping me at arm's length. Sometimes you take more than you give. And when I feel like I'm at wit's end, I hear sincerity and truth. I hear you. So say it. Don't you know that you're my everything? I love you. You're my rock. And time seems to stop. I don't trust you. You say you miss me right after I leave. And if all you get is 5 minutes, it's all right, because you got to be next to me. And when you're next to me, you inhale me as if you found heaven sent. I don't trust you. So every day I struggle. When we're not on the same page, I don't wonder if it's me. I wonder if it's meant to be. Because when you shut down, it frustrates me on levels I can't explain. And I can't explain how your love courses through my veins, and how when I want you, my body just aches. How your kisses make everything okay, I don't trust you. I wonder how you find my smile through my tears, and how I always wish that you were here. And right now, I wish that you were here. You have this way with your words, and sometimes you get on my nerves, but when you seem broken, I want to fix you. You say you need me, your glue, I don't trust you. As far as I can throw you, so scared. Scared because the truth is that I love you. We are so connected, and it feels like we're destined, and now we got time invested. And now I'm not sure if you're heaven sent, but when I inhale your scent, I become weak. She say, you got me, I don't trust you. But you knew. You said that meeting me changed your life. So you played with my heart vigorously, repairing pieces of it daily, tying love knots made pure as praline candy, solid and sweet. Still unsure, but you make me feel so full. And as I reflect on time that passed, reflect on things and people that didn't last, I believe that you're different. Because when I'm alone with you, I feel home with you. I feel safe with you. So what if? What if I just trust that I'm supposed to be with you?
Snap, snap, toe tap.
Absolutely.
Snap, snap. Gotta trust yourself. Snap, snap.
All right. And now it is time to see what many money-making thoughts that Ronnie B has for us. Ronnie, take it away.
Thank you, Sonny. Yeah, sometimes you can you trust yourself? Celebrate the consequences. Do you pay a price for your actions, or do you reap great rewards from them? Do you fear the consequences of what you do, or do you eagerly await those consequences? It all depends on the actions you take. The destination at which you arrive is determined by the direction in which you most consistently travel. Instead of cursing the negative consequences, simply avoid the actions that cause them. Instead of wistfully wishing in vain for the things you seek, just take the actions that will bring those things into your life. Everything in your life is the result of one thing or another. You can't avoid consequences, yet you can determine which ones you get. Put yourself in a position to celebrate the consequences with positive purpose, focus, effort, and persistence. The very best of life results can be yours. Most of what happens to you happens because of you. Use your actions to move solidly toward those consequences that you'll delight in celebrating. What I've learned about myself and growing my mind when it comes to the theme, celebrating the consequences and the action I will take, is one, what I've learned is that if I'm not celebrating the consequences, then I'm not doing what I should be doing. Because there's no reason for, as blessed as I am, to not be happy. And that does not mean that tragedy events won't happen in my life. They will. But there's no reason ongoingly that I'm not celebrating my consequences. And the action I will take is to vocalize my happiness. Now it's time for our special interview with Kevin Hopkins. And this part of the show, we will learn about a challenge Kevin faced in having his dreams fulfilled, a challenge that knocked the wind out of his sails. Somehow, some way, he kept going and turned that challenge from seeming defeat to victory. Thank you, Kevin, for being on the show tonight.
Thank you for having me.
Well, Kevin, we're going to dive right into it. And, Kevin, please share an incident or time in your life that knocked the wind out of your sails, when the going got even rougher and you felt like you were lost. Please be as specific as possible so we can truly appreciate what you were experiencing.
Okay, I guess I can go back to, like, the year was, like, 1996. I was in a relationship with my youngest son's mother, and I was going through a horrific time with dealing with myself and drug addiction and street life, gang violence, and so forth. And what knocked the wind out of me is when I had the inability to just not think straight and make good decisions. And I ended up taking free trips around Texas free with silver bracelets, you know. My family traveling 200-400 miles to come visit me on a weekend. The violence that was going on in the prisons, the jail cells, you know, it was a particularly rough time in my life, and you know, And it really knocked the wind out of me, you know, when the judge told me that I had to do that much time. It was something that I just couldn't come over. I wanted to blame everybody because my father.
Let's just go back one second, okay?
Okay.
Did you say given what you said up to the point where that judge, where the verdict, boom, the wind hadn't really been knocked out of your sails. Now, you might have went through stuff, but like you said, at that moment, that's when the wind got knocked out of your sails.
Yes.
And was your family there when the verdict came down?
No, they wasn't. Oh, no.
Mm.
It was just me, myself, and I.
Wow.
You know, I was there. I was representing myself because I didn't trust a public defender, and I just represented myself. But somehow, some way, you know, the judge still found me guilty, and I had to accept what I had done. You know, I had to accept the consequences, like, you know, what you were saying previously. You know, what you said, you know, reminds me of so much of what my mother used to, tell me is a cause and an effect to everything in life. And I didn't understand that until that judge, you know, put that gavel on the bench.
Mm. It was definitely just like a reality got was awoken. Now, okay, and we get that you know, you were a guest of the state at our expense, and we're going to send you a bill. And okay. Now during that time that, you know, and I'll just say that. And this might be like the total incarceration, but during that time that you were dealing, and we'll just say with your incarceration, did you find yourself blaming people, the circumstances, yourself, the judge, God?
And I blamed everybody but me. Anybody that I can blame, I blamed everybody but me. I mean, if I blamed it on the red light. Because, you know, the car didn't, you know, because the light didn't go fast enough. You know, if the lights would have went fast enough, if they had clicked, maybe the lawman wouldn't have caught me. You know what I'm saying? The police officer wouldn't have, the car in front of me would have been able to move out the way, and I could have went around. You know, I could have blamed everybody and anything. You know, I blamed churches. I blame pastors, ministers. They taught me things. They were, you know, trying to teach me things. And you know, it was just things that I could blame anyway. Like I said, I could say my father wasn't there. My mother was a single mother, you know, trying to raise me. You know, she moved away from where I was born in New Mexico. You know, I moved here to Houston. It was so many things.
You said you had the full gamut of blame.
Man, I could have blamed everybody and anything, but, you know, it was still me. You know, until I looked at me, it was a whole bunch of people I could have blamed.
Okay. Well, I'm not talking about who you could have. We're talking about who you did blame.
Well,
and it sounds like you didn't miss anybody.
I didn't. Believe me, when I was doing my soul searching, yeah, believe me, I was putting it all down on paper, man, that everybody had something to do with it.
Okay. Well, at what point did you stop? And I'm going to be real rigorous with what I'm saying.
Okay.
At what point did you stop caring about who or what to blame?
I guess that had to come like around like in the year 2000 or something. I got into a little situation while I was incarcerated, and when they put me in a single cell by myself for a little, and there was no one to interact with, and I couldn't. That's when I stopped caring, You know, I didn't care if they brought me, you know, brought me something to eat or not. I didn't care if they took me to the showers or not. You know, I didn't care if they brought my mail or not. You know, I didn't care at all. I just didn't care. You know, it was a real low life, real point in my life.
Now, when would you say you started to see the light of hope and possibility, and what steps did you take to start the journey toward that light?
I believe 2003. I came home and started listening to some people. You know, well, maybe they're right. You know, maybe they do have the answers. You know, because evidently what I'm doing ain't working.
you were willing to be a little bit humble. Okay, got it. You were a little bit humble, a little bit.
Yeah. You know, because, you know, what I saw was these people, they were enjoying life. They were laughing. They were going places. And I thought they were still, you know, doing something around the corner somewhere, really. But they just didn't want to let me know. You know, because I hadn't fully accepted, you know, this way of life, you know. And so, things just kept going on and going on. But I had hope at that time.
So you, at that time, you had hope. And what steps did you start taking?
The steps that I started taking was, you know, looking in the mirror. You know, when I started looking in the mirror, at one point, one morning I got up and I was looking in the mirror and I kind of like, you know, tried to turn around real quick to see if somebody else was there, you know, but it was just me, you know, and I figured out that it's me. I'm the problem. I'm the problem. You know, nobody else is the problem. It's me. And I had to start, you know, really opening, you know, take the cotton out of my ears and put it in my mouth and listen to some of the things that some of these gentlemen that were trying to teach me how to live life on life terms.
Wow, that's awesome. Awesome, awesome. Well, Kevin, I thank you for sharing and being so straightforward and honest. And we might give you a discount on that bill.
I appreciate that. But you can still mail
okay. All right. Well, I have a feeling that you done made up for it. But we'll just call that a graduate school.
Yes.
Okay, we'll just call that the graduate school of life. Now, thinking about our theme, okay, our theme was celebrate the consequences. What words of wisdom would you share with our listeners? Celebrate the consequences.
Again, celebrating consequences, you have to be willing to accept negative or positive consequences regardless to your actions. You know, the celebrating the consequences that I have today, everything in life has a reward. I mean, if you strive for negativity, that's what you get, negativity. If you strive for positivity, to be productive in life, those are the things that you reap. And in celebrating those things, you take time to smell the roses. You take time to enjoy family, life today, breathing. You know, I'm so fortunate, you know, that I have a family member that's my mother, my pride and joy, you know, and I love spending time with her whenever I can. If I'm not working, you know, I spend time with her because, you know, she's giving me life, and I try to give it back to her as much as possible. I celebrate life, celebrate the consequences of my actions with my children. I'm a grandfather now, and you know, I love spending time with my grandbaby. You know, and it's just, you know, just enjoying life today, life on life terms.
Enjoying life on life terms. All right. There's some wisdom there, and we want to thank you for sharing. Now, listeners, we'll hear more from Kevin later in the show, but it is time for A Prosperous Spirit with Miss Cookie. Well, it looks like we might be having a bit of a technical difficulty with Miss Cookie. And, there they got it fixed. They got it fixed. Miss Cookie, over to you.
Thank you, Ronnie B. Let go, let God. I let go and let God guide my feet, my life. Sometime event, people, or situations may not live up to my expectations. I may feel disappointed, let down, or angry. My first thought may be to look for someone to blame. I may want to force an outcome or think about running away. In these moments, I release tension, fears, and judgment and realign my spirit. As I fell deeper into prayer, I am willing to release whatever may be bothering me. I realize I don't have to know the who, how, or when of a resolution, only that it will happen in its perfect timing and place. I affirm patience and faith, knowing I am blessed in ways beyond my current understanding. Shani, take us to break.
Stay tuned for The Kitchen with Miss Cookie and Quiet Song featuring music from Inobe. On the corner.
Another day. Another restless night, crying myself to sleep. Another day of relentless phone calls from credit card companies demanding payment. Another day wondering if filing bankruptcy or getting one of those debt consolidation loans is the only way to go. A friend said, stop crying. Call Sharon, the debt destroyer. Sharon and her team of experts work hard to help you eliminate your credit card debt and get you and your credit back on track. No bankruptcy. No loans? Your credit card debt eliminated? I called Sharon, and her team of experts went right to work with a plan that made sense. I am sleeping peacefully, knowing my credit card debt is being destroyed, and my credit is getting back on track. Have your credit card debt destroyed, and get a good night's sleep. Contact Sharon, the debt destroyer, at yourdebtdestroyer.com or call 888-431-2829, extension 2.
Welcome back. We give it all to you and Grow Your Mind and Money. And baby, you better believe that we do it all with love. Okay. So something smells great. It's got to be this dish Miss Cookie is whipping up in this kitchen. Miss Cookie, what you got going on over there?
Thank you. I have a delicious, scrumptious dish, and it's 2-in-1. It will make your store-bought loaf bread taste gourmet by sandwiching and roasted garlic and herbs. Now, it is roasted garlic herb bread. It takes 15 minutes of preparation. It serves 12. So welcome to the kitchen. we have this great recipe I've just described for you that has been working diligently on growing their mind and money. Tonight, I would like for you to get your pen and paper handy. Here comes your ingredients for the roasted garlic herb bread. You will need 2 heads fresh garlic, 2 tablespoons of olive oil, 3 tablespoons snipped fresh Italian flat leaf parsley, 1 tablespoon of snipped fresh basil, organic and or thyme, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1/4 teaspoon of freshly ground black pepper, 1 10- to 12-ounce loaf whole grain Italian bread. Your directions are: preheat your oven to 425 degrees. Peel away the dry outer layer of skin from the head of garlic, leaving skin, and cover the cloves intact. Cut off the point top portion about 1/4 inch, leaving bud intact but exposing the individual cloves. Place each garlic head cut side up in a custard cup. Drizzle each with about 1/4 teaspoon of the olive oil. Cover with foil. Bake for 25 to 35 minutes or until the cloves feel soft when pressed. Set aside until cool enough to handle. Number 2, squeeze out the garlic paste from individual cloves into a small bowl. Mash the garlic cloves with a fork. Stir in remaining olive oil, the parsley, basil, salt, and pepper. Without cutting through the bottom crust, cut bread into 12 slices. Spread garlic mixture between slices, spreading on one side only of each slice. Wrap the loaf in heavy foil. Bake 12 minutes until heated thoroughly. Serve it warm with this cozy fall flavored slow cooker sausage lasagna. I need those pens and paper handy again. For your slow cooker sausage lasagna, you will need 1 pound of Johnsville ground mild Italian sausage, or you can use the links, just decase it. You will need 1 pound of ground beef, 1 medium onion finely chopped, 1 garlic clove minced, 1 jar 24-ounce spaghetti sauce, or you can make your own spaghetti sauce, 1 can 14-ounce diced tomatoes in sauce, undrained, 1/2 cup of water, 1 teaspoon of dried basil, 1 teaspoon of dried oregano, 1 carton 15 ounces wholemeal ricotta cheese, 2 eggs lightly beaten, 1/2 cup grated Parmesan cheese, 9 uncooked lasagna noodles, 4 cups 16 ounces shredded part skim mozzarella cheese. Get that slow cooker by line the sides of an oval 6-quart slow cooker with heavy-duty foil. With cooking spray, coat it. In a Dutch oven, cook sausage, beef, onion, and garlic over medium heat 8 to 10 minutes or until meat is no longer pink, breaking up sausage and beef into crumbles. Drain, stir in the spaghetti sauce, water, and herbs. Heat thoroughly. In a small bowl, mix the ricotta cheese, eggs, and Parmesan cheese. Spread 1/2 cup meat sauce onto the bottom of prepared slow cooker. Layer with 3 noodles breaking to fit. 3/4 cup of ricotta mix. 1 cup of mozzarella cheese and 2 cups of meat sauce. Repeat layers twice. Sprinkle with remaining mozzarella cheese. Cook covered on low 3.5 to 4 hours until mousse are tender. Turn off slow cooker. Remove. Insert from slow cooker. Let stand 15 minutes before serving. Now you have your bread and your lasagna. Feast on your delicious meal. You can cook that lasagna while you're at work. Now it is time for the corner with Quiet Storm. Let's give her a smooch and a rose.
And I thank you, Miss Cookie. That sounded like a delicious treat. Well, tonight we are featuring music from Inobe. Now, she's out of Los Angeles, California, with her self-titled album, Inobe. And as you know, we ask our team to vote whether the tracks we play should get a smooch and a rose, or if they really need more, sometimes much more, fertilizing. Now, the name of our first track is She's Fly. Strike up the band, Ronnie.
She's in the glory. Never can tell when her tank is here. That's just her style.
Her shoes are a few years old. She shouts and rocks, searching her clothes. And it might as well be gold. There's not in debt, and she's rich in her soul. She's either going and carefree. Never to tell, never to tell when her time's on E. That's just her thing. Yeah, that's just her thing. In all situations, she never complained, y'all.
She's fine. Yeah, she's fine. She's fine.
That was She's Fly. Well, is the track Getting a Smooch and a Rose or Some Free Fertilizer? Miss Cookie, you are up first.
Looks like we still might be having a little technical difficulty with Miss Cookie.
Okay.
Go ahead. Keep going, Quiet Storm.
All right. All right. Next up is Shawnee. Shawnee, what did you think about She's Fly?
I'm going to give her a whole bunch of smooches and dozens of roses because she is definitely fly. I love that track.
That's great. Okay. Excellent. Moving down the line, Miss Nikki, was she fly?
I loved it. I absolutely loved it. Smooches and roses, baby. Smooches and roses.
Okay, it is rolling in. Let's go to our guest, Kevin. Kevin, what did you think of that track?
I give it a smooch and a rose. It was pretty fly to me.
All right. It is almost unanimous. Mr. Ronnie B.
I like that Inobe. She fly.
Yeah.
And it is. It is definitely unanimous. She is fly. So we are going to fly to our next track. Now, the name of this track, of course, from the same artist, this track is titled Badada. Badada. Let's check it out.
Mm-hmm.
Like a queen, I get butterflies.
Well, you heard it for yourself. That was ba-da-da. Yes, so we're going right to our panel and find out exactly what they thought. And first up, let's go to Miss Nikki.
I like butterfly. I'll give that a smooch and a rose.
Okay, a smooch and a rose. All right, right out of the box. Okay. Well, let's see. Johnny, what you got?
I like it. I still like she fly a little bit more. So I'm still going to give a smooch, but I'm keeping my roses.
Oh, my God. Okay, that is an interesting read. All right. Mr. Kevin.
I'm going to give her a smooch and a rose. It was real relaxing.
Mm.
Like, you know, it was real relaxing. I almost fell asleep.
Okay. All right. All right. Well, that is a very fair. Do we have Miss Cookie back?
Yes. And all of those smooches and rose people, I want your fertilizer.
Okay.
That is right. Let's get real. Miss Cookie is a no for this one. And I'm not going to fertilize it, but I will keep my smooches and give her one rose. Eight for effort.
Mm-hmm. No.
Wow. All I can say to that is ba-da-da. I'm giving her a smooch and a rose.
A smooch and a rose from Mr. Ronnie. Okay.
Is that a real smooch and a rose, or is that a sympathy smooch and a rose?
Oh, no. Hey. I go all in. I go all in. I'm with it.
He submitted it.
you could give up his fertilizer, Miss Cookie.
Yeah, I just had to. He can throw his over on mine. I know it was Brad with a cookie or something.
Oh, my goodness.
My goodness.
Well, panel has had their say. And you out there, if you like what you heard from Inobe this evening, you can check her out at Inobe.com. That is Inobe.com.
Up next, Shining Sunshine Lounge, the interview with Kevin Hopkins. Voices from the Ethers, stay tuned.
I'm Cookie, head chef at Nano's and Cookie's Southern Kitchen. Being in a rural area, it's a challenge to find the books and articles I need to keep up on the latest trends in nutrition, health, and cooking. That's why I rely on Burns & Noble Online. Burns & Noble is known for their huge selection of books, DVDs, and magazines, and you can order right from the comfort of your home. It's like they open a store right next door just for me. They even have this fancy new ebook reader called Nook. It's the world's most advanced ebook reader. It's great for keeping up with all your reading, and books are delivered instantly, no waiting, no fuss. It's been great speaking with you, but I need to get back in the kitchen. Check out that Barnes & Noble store next door to you at www.bn.com. That's www.bn.com.
I guess it's time for me to come on home. Guess I'm on my way.
Well, we do give it all to you on Grow Your Mind and Money, and yes, we do it all with love. Now it is time to visit the lounge with Shani. Take it away.
Ooh, thank you, Quiet Storm. Hey, Shani the Poet, the original.
Sunshine Princess of Poetry, and welcome to Shiny Sunshine Lounge, where we feature a mixture of goodies that will stimulate your mind and maybe having you tapping your feet. Tonight, we have an awesome poet, Amina Brown, performing Roots and Wings. Hey, DJ, that mic is hot.
I didn't mean to do it. I mean, they sold me out. And as soon as we had Mary Post in the house, I was the one that got finger pointed, pushed and shoved the funeral carpet stage, a tiny bookstore, Montgomery, Alabama. It was called Roots and Wings. And I was probably standing somewhere between these Giovanni's love poems, and I know how to change birth things, and I think I recall Mason McCall. Because it definitely made me want to holler. When I looked out at the 50s of mine, my classmates' faces staring back at me while I nervously tried my photographic memory, trying to recall the words on a page I'd written over and over again, but never imagined I'd say out loud in front of anyone. I couldn't believe that anybody's on the edge of their seat listening to me. I was only 17, but somewhere I found the courage, and it carried me line for line until the end. And even after all the hugs and smiles from friends, I was still shaking. And that's when I knew this was real. That's when I knew that words have wings, that they're kind of like birds, but mostly like children, who you groom and raise. You hope you shape them well, that a sky that has no limits will receive them that someday somebody will take them home, call them their own, that they will find a place to belong. See, I came from a line where righteousness ran through the blood like sugar and rolling stone daddy. And maybe the people who are pushing me had been here long before my classmates. Maybe my grandmother and my grandfather and their preacher sisters and brothers were pushing me too. See, they said me parables and I acquired a taste for truth. They stood behind pulpits and I stand behind this mic and just like them. I gotta get on my knees and some prayers and words don't suffice. I gotta learn to sing the hymns that cannot be found in hymn books. To lead on everlasting arms and hold fast to the words that only God can write on hearts. These hands, they never knew cotton, but the hands that did, they knew how to spin stories, knew how to sew quilts of memory so I could see my family history in stitch. And every time my grandmother speaks, I realize the words have roots, that they're kind of like trees, but mostly like seeds, who you groom and raise. You hope you plant them well, that fertile ground will receive them that someday somebody will take them home, call them their own, that they will find a place to belong. And words keep encouraging me to dream, keep reminding me that God listens when I sing, and that's how I know this is real, and I am still shaking.
All right, all right, all right. So that was Roots and Wings. So panel, is Roots and Wings getting snap snaps or Rotten Tomatoes? I am going to start with Quiet Storm. Yay!
Thank you. I was ready for this one. No, I really, really, really loved it. She is definitely getting for me some snap snaps. I loved her expression, her insight with it, her energy. Really, 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 really. I was impressed. Snap, 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 snap.
Hey, and I'm going to slide over to a poet. Nikki, how you feel about that? Snap, snaps or Rotten Tomatoes?
Man, snap, snap, jingle the keys, clap. I really loved everything about that poem. I love the delivery. I love that she could take something that could be so socially political and something so provocative and at the same time be strong and soft at the same time. It was perfect. It was flawless. I like it.
All right. Kevin.
I enjoyed it. It was very, very, it had very much insight on it. I really liked it. Get snaps from me.
Ronnie B.
I we're not going to go with the Empress, but I'm snapping it. Amina Brown, Roots and Wings. I'm with it, baby.
I'm doing this in order. I want to do this, sir.
Okay. All right. Okay. I'm just trying to go ladies.
This is not your segment.
Now, I'm finishing up with my empress. Let's see it,
look, I'm afraid to speak now. I don't want to get beat up. Thank you.
I love it. My bitch.
I'm going to give us some snaps. I totally agree with Nikki's presentation regarding this young lady's ability to speak and spill. Especially, I love when it comes down to controversial topics, and an artist is not afraid to speak up and share their genuine thoughts.
That's what's up. So, and I'm just gonna put the icing on the cake, cause she did that. I know that I'm like super duper picky in my segment. I know I'm hard on the poet. And I absolutely love this piece. Her delivery was absolutely flawless. So I hope that you enjoyed the performance by Amina Brown as much as I did. You can check her out on oldgrumpyhouston.com and YouTube. Now it is time to continue with our wonderful interview with Kevin Hopkins with our special guest interviewer, Nikki Kaplan of Business Solutions. Nikki, take it away.
All right. Kevin, thank you for your sharing and your willingness to be open and authentic. In this segment, we will learn more about Kevin and some of the challenges he faced in having his different enterprises exceed our expectations. Kevin, please share the aha moment when you knew in your heart of hearts that being a producer and business owner was the right thing for you.
Oh, wow. I guess my aha moment came about 3 years ago when I knew within my heart and my heart that, you know, I wanted to be a producer, be a business owner. At first it was a challenge, but, you know, I knew within my heart that I wanted to do something different. But being a producer in the last year or so, when I saw the smile, how the young gentleman's light eyes and the smile on his face when he got a chance to perform on a venue that we put together over at a nightclub over at the Southwest Houston, and I just knew right then that that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to help.
All right. Okay, well, what circumstances or people challenge you in having enterprises and the difference they make exceed our expectations? What are you doing to overcome those obstacles?
Learning how to deal with people in general, you know, different situations arise in the entertainment business, dealing with different customers and so forth. That you have to have people skills in order to survive in this business, you know. But again, the challenges that I have and those things that make the company that I've created and the businesses that I've started is because of the service and the people skills and what we do for the community.
Can you give an example?
Sure. One example is we had a client that wanted us to distribute some advertisement out in the Midtown area. I mean, this guy called me. We were in Dallas at the time, and he called me for like 12 times. You know, just bugging and worrying. What time would I get here? What time would I be back? And when we finally met, and we finally, you know, agreed on this area and signed the contract and everything, you know, the service that we provided for him, and he got so many calls, and he was so delighted, you know. It just made us feel good, made him feel good, made us, it was a job well done.
Oh, wow. Okay. Would you be willing to share?
Well, Kevin, let me just kind of ask you a little bit more. Just
What was the challenge?
The challenge was getting him to understand that you don't have to call me every 5 minutes. That was the challenge. You know, if you're trusting me to do a service for you, let me do my job. Let us do our job. You know, you hired us to do a specific job, and that was to distribute your advertisement in the neighborhood of Midtown. Let us do it. Well, where are you at? Where are you at? So we implemented some things. We implemented.
Well, just hold that thought for one moment.
Okay.
Because earlier when Shani's poem was what? Trust.
Yeah.
And so you'd say one of your biggest challenges is having your clients trust that the job is going to get done.
Of course. And, okay, I can trust you.
Okay. All right, Nikki, back to you. but go ahead. Keep going, but it's back to Nikki. Go ahead, Catherine.
Okay. I can trust you. Because I have trust. I know how to imply trust. But other people are different people don't know how to imply trust in business. They will ask for a service and hire you for a service, but then they want answers fast, quick, and in a hurry, like a computer. You know, and it's not like that. You know, the trust has to be built, and that's where the people skills come in. If you're not able to communicate effectively with your customer, it's not going to build the trust. So I had to take time, stop, pull over. Hey, look, brother, say, sir, you know, this is the service that we provide. If I have to stop and call you every 5 minutes when we're, you know, putting a flyer on the door, you're holding me up. You know, so that's why we had to build this trust. So that's why I implemented the picture texting throughout the time that we distribute the flyers.
Wow.
And that's what makes us different from a lot of other flyer distributor companies. What makes us different in the production company and the OTP and the on-time production is that we focus on upcoming artists that are making a difference in the community and have a positive impact and have a positive message. If you're saying something negative, if you're talking about rape, robbery, and kill, that's not something that we stand behind, because we're not a record company, first of all, but we're not going to put you in a venue or something where our clients are going to be subject to that type of language and environment. So we have a purpose. Hello?
Yes, I like that. Now, would you be willing to share a disappointment that involved working with others that still has you shake your head, Kevin?
Would I be willing to share a disappointment that still has me shaking my head?
Yes, that involved you working with others.
The trust that I put in some of my employees.
Okay, let's talk about it.
Dealing with the employees that I have, we have like up to 18, you know, some of them, not all of them, some of them, it's very difficult. We were talking about this earlier. I mean, I don't know how hard it gets for you to just follow instructions. It's not, I don't know, how does anybody know how much a piece of paper weighs? Less than a couple of ounces? It's not heavy, anything. It's just put it on the door. You're not there to make a spill. You're not there to sell anything. You're not there to knock on the door. You're not there to ring the doorbell. Just put the piece of paper on the door and keep moving. I mean, sometimes it is hard to get a couple of my guys to do that. They're willing to do the work. They'll skip a house here, and I'm like, man, don't do that. You can't skip a house. And, well, I don't want to walk across the grass. Man, then they'll act, well, I gotta go walk. I have to walk down the sidewalk and walk back up the driveway. Man, listen, man, we have these bright vests on. We have these safety vests on. We have these safety hats off. Everybody in the neighborhood knows that we're out here. Even the constables and the sheriffs and the police, because Adrian Garcia did endorse us. They know us. they know who I am. You know, they know my company, and, you know, everybody knows. So you're not breaking any laws. You're not breaking in anybody's house, and you're not breaking, you know, you're not doing anything illegal. You're just putting a piece of paper on a door. That's it. And that's the, you know, those are the challenges that I have. I still have shaking my head because, you know, sometimes jobs run longer. Sometimes they're quick. It just depends on these two guys that I have. And some, I still shake my head too. Today they make me laugh, but you know, but it tickles me because they have the drive. It's just that they get coming from the neighborhood that they come from, you know, it's different, a different setting. You know, when they travel out of town, it's something new because they've never been outside of Houston or outside of downtown. And when we take them to Dallas, or when we take them to San Antonio, we take them to Austin, Corpus Christi, we've been as far as Laredo one time, and you know, just distributing flyers. And these guys is new to them. You know, and these are young men that have dropped out of school, that have, you know, don't have direction, don't have the self-esteem that we give them, that opportunity to get some self-esteem, to get some honest money, to be able to walk to success one flyer at a time.
Man, okay. That's pretty awesome. So please share. Now, I heard a little bit of this when you were speaking, when you were sharing the story about developing trust and the customer was calling you every 5 minutes. But can you please share a specific moment where your effort and the memories of the work you and others did still brings a smile to your face?
Oh, wow. I guess the smile on my face. I get a smile on every job, really, because it's not about the money. It's really not about the money. It's about the joy that I
But tell us
get.
About a specific job.
I guess when we were
specific. Well, actually, it doesn't have to even be a specific job.
I have to say one of the San Antonio jobs that we did a job where it was address specific, and that's where a customer gives us addresses to specifically place a door hanger on a door, and it brings me joy because this official, this city official in San Antonio was elected, and because of some of the effort and because of the hard work and effort that me and my team put in.
Okay. Well, you know, Kevin, we could talk.
Wow. Let's just step back a second here. Wow. Okay. So you and your team got someone elected.
I wouldn't say got elected.
You're just being modest. Okay, but
yeah,
you.
We helped in that.
Yeah, but that brought a smile to your face.
Yeah, that brought a smile because at the end result, when election time came, she won. You know, and it was because of, it was because of, you know, some of the effort that we helped with, along with others, put the information out for her to be elected.
Okay. All right. Let me get that back to Nikki.
Well, I was saying that we could talk forever, Kevin, but it's time to hear from our listeners. So, Quiet Storm, what do you hear from the ethers?
Well, Miss Nikki, and that was a very powerful interview. I want to thank both of you for that. But it is time to hear some voices from our listeners, and that is voices from the ethers. Let's pull up our first, yes, here it is, our first voice, and this listener writes, snap, snap, snap. The poetry from Lady Farrar was amazing. Color Me Pretty is deep. The entire show was perfect, especially your guest, Nikki. I can see why she is so successful. You are either going to take actions or talk about taking actions. Love, Ronnie B. He has a great way of working with each guest, and we definitely know all of that is so true. That came from Miss Patricia McCausland, and we so thank you. Moving on to that next voice, and let's see. Yes. This listener writes, Nikki's conversation with Nakia was just what I needed to hear. Time to stop being a victim of the challenges. Time to take some actions. Wow. That is right in line with the theme running through tonight's show. That comment came from Osama Willow. Thank you so much for taking the time to let us know how you feel. And, of course, listening to the show and supporting us. And we have so many voices from the ether. Let's see which one. Okay, well, this listener writes, Nakia, I love how you and the interviewers go to the wire to have the guests speak from the heart. You simply refuse to allow them to give you an off-the-cuff response. And you are a demand that they really think through their response and share unabashedly, all in a loving, powerful context. I don't know you. I don't know how you pull this off week after week with guests who have totally different backgrounds, like 60 Minutes meets Oprah combined with Star Search. Wow, this is rich and transforming. Nakia, I am so glad you opened the door for Miss Nikki to drop the typical height and embrace her heart and soul while sharing her life with us. I was left moved, touched, inspired, and I was hanging on every word. Miss Nikki had me look at my petty issues. And I saw, and I say, petty because I saw from her, sharing that I make mountains out of molehills. And my lack of success in business is because I can't wait to have a problem to use as a distraction to not do the work. Wow, that is incredible insight. I want my business to be easier than my regular job, which is impossible to do after 20 years. My job is easier for me to do. I started doing the prosperity work, and I see how lazy I am about doing a couple of simple exercises. I will talk you to death about ideas and how things should work, but when you say take some actions, I come up with arguments and discussions without taking the first steps. The music from Raphael Ashanti and the poetry blew me away. This was a very fun show. I can't thank Miss Nikki enough. She was totally inspiring. Smooches and roses to Nakia. She really is the Empress of Faith. Love you. Wow. That was from Catherine Holmes. And Catherine, I'm certain that Nakia and Nikki both love you for your comments and your insights. Let's get in yet another. We had a lot of responses to that show. Now this
you can
person,
only take a short one.
This person writes, I like Nikki and Nakia. They are my rolling on the floor and crying. They had me rolling on the floor and crying at the same time. All right, that one was from Jennifer Garcia. And Jennifer, thank you for that. We definitely appreciate you taking the time to let us know and support the show. And that was Voices from the Ethers. Nakia, please take us to break.
Absolutely. Coming up next, in the next segment, the finale, with Kevin Hopkins, Food for Thought, and the prosperity work. Stay tuned.
Yeah. Pay someone to give me coaching when what I need is to make more money. Let's get real. You are already making money if you can afford to pay a so-called coach to get you to the next level. Ever hear the old saying, those who can, do. Those who can't, coach. Seems like a whole bunch of so-called life or business coaches do nothing but sell the need for coaching. I was more than skeptical when it came to paying a coach to help me make more money in my business. Margaret Bassant's Elegant Coaching is about fulfilling desires now, not later, which blew me away. Week one. I am critical, suspicious, skeptical, and disagreeable. Margaret trains us on seeing what is hidden from our view. Week two, I am beginning to pinpoint the exact actions I take when making the moves critical to growing my business that are keeping it from growing wildly. I am less skeptical, critical, and suspicious. Margaret trains us how to put the past in the past and bring completion to decisions that are impacting our present and future effectiveness. Week three, my company doubled its sales income and I made a lot more money, a lot more. I want more coaching. Margaret Passant's Elegant Coaching, fulfilling desires now, not later.
Welcome back. We give it all to you on Grow Your Mind and Money. Uh-huh. We do it all with love. All right. It is time for the finale. Quiet Storm, over to you, love.
Thank you so much, Johnny. Well, Kevin, it really has been a very, very special treat for me listening to you and having you on the show. I so want to thank you for coming and sharing with us. I have to say, you know, when I heard you mention the last interview, you used the phrase walking to success one flyer at a time. I just thought that was so genius. I just really, really appreciate that. And, you know, your authenticity, you express a lot of joy, you know, working with the people you work with, your employees, and the talent. So it's just so authentic and real. And the fact that you have made all of your businesses successful, it's really a pleasure having you on the show.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me. And thank all the people that are associated with the station, Mr. Ronnie, Mr. Nikita, and Nikki, and Ms. Cookie, who's gone, and you too, Ms. Quiet Storm.
All right. Well, thank you for that. And just to go ahead and jump right into it, do you see any changes lurking around kind of in the water, so to speak, that can take you down or just take you off the path altogether from having your businesses succeed beyond expectations?
Of course I do. I see them. Mm-hmm. I see them every day. You know, and those things that I face, each and every individual faces every day, is the decisions that you make. You have a choice each day to do something right or do something wrong. If I choose to do something wrong, it's, again, we're back to the theme, celebrating the consequences. Mm-hmm. You know, if I do something wrong and choose to do something wrong intentionally, guess what? The consequences will show. So, you know, it's all about making the right decisions today.
Well, Kevin, I'm just going to throw in, because the question is worded a certain way for a purpose. And what challenges do you see lurking in the water that would try to slow you down or take you off the path from having your business succeed beyond expectation?
What is the challenges that you already see? They're lurking. Their little noses are sticking up through the water.
Again, I'm going to reiterate, it's my thinking, because I can't blame
you. Oh, okay, you know, your thinking, okay.
My thinking, the choices that I make, I have a decision to do something every day, either do something wrong or do something right. And if I choose intentionally and knowingly to do something that's not right, the consequences I will pay. And those consequences end up not allowing me to be successful in the area that I am, that I'm in.
I just wanted to step back for one moment, though. But it's the challenge is your thinking. And why I'm saying that is, and illustrating it is that, one, because you said it, that the challenge is the thinking. Because then the thinking is what leads to you making the choice.
A choice, right.
Right. So, okay, just wanted to clarify that a little bit. Quiet storm, back to you.
Okay. Well, Kevin, let me just find out. Now, when it comes to being consistent, what?
No, I'm sorry, quiet storm. I gotta stop. We really need to kind of be rigorous with the question.
Okay. Well, please share two pitfalls that you have seen people fall into when it comes to being consistent in their actions for growing their careers, wealth, health, or well-being.
Two pitfalls?
If you had to narrow it down to two pitfalls.
I mean, it would be, again, choices. I mean, every day. My thing, pitfalls that I've seen people make are bad decisions. And they go into bad ventures that they don't do their research. They don't do, they don't market right, and they don't take advantage of what's out there for them to take advantage for in business. Like, Nikki's business. You know, which I'll be talking to her soon about anyway. Those are the pitfalls. You have to take advantage of what's out there. If you don't, you know, you won't be successful.
So lack of using their resources. And what was that second pitfall?
The second pitfall is the resources and just research.
Yeah,
you don't do the research if you don't do the research on the business that you're venturing into. If there's a need, if somebody else is into it, how many people are involved in this venture and so forth. You just have to do your research. If you don't do your research, it's not gonna happen. I mean, you're gonna make a bad decision. You end up investing a lot of money, a lot of time, and then when you don't succeed or you're not getting the response that you feel or you think that you should have, you get depressed and and next thing you know, you're out of business.
I can definitely get that. And I know that a lot of folks who have started businesses can definitely get that as well. You have to get over that stage.
Right.
Well, would you please share with us one practice, just one practice that you use daily to keep yourself in action and focus on the results you intend to produce?
Marketing. I do a lot of marketing. I'm in contact daily. It's a daily, it's like a ritual. It's almost like a prayer that I do. You know, I have to market. If I don't market, then there's no results. You have to plant seeds.
So marketing is would be your daily practice.
Yeah, definitely.
All right. Yeah, you want to say more about
morning.
That?
Yeah, I'm up early in the morning, 3-4 o'clock in the morning. I'm up late at night marketing. Sometimes during the day when I have a break, I'm marketing. You know, and when I go into places or different businesses and so forth, I'm always on alert. Marketing. I'm always looking for the opportunity to present OTP, OTFs, on-time flyers, on-time productions. I'm always looking for the opportunity.
Hmm. Okay. Well, I have definitely heard the adage that a closed mouth doesn't get fed.
Definitely. Definitely.
Well, I do want to find out from you, what do you have on your plate coming up or going on right now? And how can our listeners learn more about the projects and other activities that you're involved with?
Okay. Well, first, with the projects that I have right now are, we got like over on the on-time flyer business, on-time flyer delivery service, we have over 100,000 flyers ordered for delivery between the next 2 weeks for the Christmas lightings and so forth. And on the OTP side, on-time productions, we are marketing for, we're a marketing team for a local artist called The Tyrone Bank. And he's a local artist. And he's doing a lot in the community, and we really, really enjoy his music. And he has a positive message, and so that's why we stand so strongly behind him. And we, you know, you can look him up on thebyronbank.com, and you can check his music out. On the Together We Change, which is the organization that I created, is aimed at the at-risk population. It's the core of everything else that I operate in. We're getting ready to launch a magazine. The magazine will be aimed at those that need jobs, employment, housing, just need the resources, need the information for the resources. Wow. It's also going to be, it's also going to be for the general public. The general public, where they can put their advertisements in, and it's social change. It's social change, and we want the society. We would like to have the society. Our goal is to reintegrate the transition from people being incarcerated, homeless, and the chronic illnesses to people having an opportunity to get jobs, housing, and so forth. We want to, bring a different light to the social change, because, I teach my son, I teach my daughters, I teach all my employees that don't wear your pants hanging down. Take that scarf off your head. Wear your hat correctly. You don't need a bunch of chains and jewelry because you're already stigmatized by the way that you look. So you need to change your image. You need to change the way that you look and the way that you present yourself so you can have a better opportunity to make a living for yourself. It's something that I had to go through myself. It wasn't easy. It's like pulling teeth, I love working with them because, that's the area that's where I came from, and being that I've been down in the dirt and been under the bridge and, been there, I lead by example. If I can do it, you can do it. And I've made a nice career out of myself, for myself. And I want you to do the same thing. And not only do we help them in that area, we also mentor them in business. If they have a business idea, any type of business idea, we teach them how to be entrepreneurs for themselves. Mm. We teach them how to go down and get the DBA. We teach them how to go open the bank account. We show them how to market for themselves so they can be productive members of society. That's what our goal is, that Together We Change. because we want to stop the recidivism that's going on in our Texas prisons, in our jails, in our institutions, and so forth.
Wow, Kevin, I really want to thank you for sharing yourself, for being there for the people and caring about the people that work for you, as well as the people that you're promoting as talent. It's very evident that, you know, you derive a lot of pleasure out of just helping people uplift themselves. So I want to definitely thank you for being on Grow Your Mind and Money. And please come back and visit us again.
I will. Thank you for having me again.
Well, coming up next, I wonder what special dish Nakia has whipped up for us today on Food for Thought.
Thank you, Quarstorm. Thank you. Food for Thought. Celebrate the consequences. Do you pay a price for your actions, or do you reap great rewards from them? Do you fear the consequences of what you do, or do you eagerly await those consequences? It all depends on the actions you take. The destination at which you arrive is determined by the direction in which you most consistently travel. Instead of cursing the negative consequences, simply avoid the actions that cause them, instead of wishfully wishing in vain for the things you seek. Just take the actions that will bring those things into your life. Everything in your life is the result of one thing or another. You can't avoid consequences, yet you can determine which ones you get. Put yourself in a position to celebrate the consequences with positive purpose. Focus, effort, and persistence. The very best of life's results can be yours. Most of what happens to you happens because of you. Use your actions to move solidly toward those consequences that you'll delight in celebrating. Wow. Whew. An action I see I can take for myself when it comes to the theme, celebrate the consequences, is to first remove the negative barriers that blocks me from pushing forth into my destiny. Once I break down those walls, then I can see clearly through those things that I have ambition to achieve. And then the step that I take next is to simply do it and celebrate the victories in the numerous amounts of milestones that come with each step I take forward without looking back and without regret. Over to Ronnie B. for the prosperity work.
Celebrate those consequences. And we had listeners love this piece of prosperity work, so we're going to do a review. How to free yourself from being stuck. There are times when it seems we're going round and round and round in a vicious circle, getting nowhere fast. It seems as though we have failed. The work we have done is fruitless. We have simply wasted our time. What if your seeming failures are not truly failures? What if those seeming failures are perfect and you are perfect? What if where you are right now in this particular spot is exactly where you need to be for your most cherished dreams and desires to manifest in reality? When you begin the process of blessing your world and the people in your world, you begin to free yourself from being stuck in the illusions of failure. Find something to bless in your world. Find people to bless in your world. Most importantly, find something to bless yourself for. You are a blessing, and the more you bless yourself, others, and your world, the quicker you free yourself from being stuck. The work. Create a list of 10 things about yourself, others, and your world that you will create a reason to bless. Each day, bless the items on your list aloud in a mirror repeatedly until you are moved, touched, and inspired by the person in the mirror. Say this affirmation daily. I bless all that I have and all that I hope to have now. I bless all that I have and look with wonder at its increase now. Share your list with at least one person daily and invite them to participate. And remember, demand a miracle.
A world of peace and prosperity, one listener at a time. Until next time, grow your mind. And your money.
If you would like to learn more about our fantastic guest, Kevin Hopkins, you can visit him on Facebook, Kevin Hopkins, On Time Flyer Delivery, Together We Change, On Time Productions, OTP, and he is available on Instagram, Twitter, Tumblr, and again on LinkedIn as Kevin Hopkins. Fantastic guest, fantastic guy. Support him and empower your own business. Check him out. Oh, don't want to forget his direct phone number, 832-503-1617. Check him out, Kevin Hopkins, On Time Flyer Delivery, Together We Change, and On Time Productions.